When we load our beers into the fermenters, we use conical fermentation vessels, and we use a live cultured yeast that's loaded in the bottom of that. So when we take that hot beer out of the brew kettle, it goes through a heat transfer unit to get it to the right temperature. And as he mentioned earlier, we're going to ferment our ales, and we brew all ales. We have brewed lagers for special events and specialty beers and stuff that he gets to play with. But when we go in, we've got to get that beer. It's real important to get it from 214 degrees or 220 degrees, where we have it up to boil, down to that right temperature so we don't kill the yeast. So it goes through a heat transfer, goes in the bottom of that cone, forces in, and just blows up that yeast. And so it fills up the fermentation vessel with all this yeast and mixing it up. So that's kind of serves, that cone serves two processes. It lets the yeast fall down and get out of the way. But when we start it, we get to go in there and mess that yeast up and get it going. And as he talked about, it's top fermenting. So the ales ferment faster. I mean, they'll start fermenting within 24 hours, sometimes faster than that. And it ferments from the top down, you know, so that gets a chance to fall in as that yeast does what it does. And yeast, you know, it's an organism. It does what everything does. It consumes, reproduces, and excretes, you know, and it makes a byproduct, you know. And it's not the prettiest way to say it, but that's what we do as humans. And so its byproducts are obviously alcohol, which is what we're wanting to get it. And the main things, byproducts are a lot of things, but it creates alcohol, creates a natural carbonation, so we get a CO2 in there. That is natural, and it does some other things in there. It creates, releases diacetyl and reclaims diacetyl towards the end as it rests, but it does a lot of different things. But that's like I said, where the magic happens. That's where alcohol is created. And, you know, beer's not beer without alcohol, no matter what O'Doul's and those guys say. But, you know, that's what we're here to make. We're here to make an alcoholic beverage, and we've done all the processes, and that's where we get to add that last ingredient, the yeast. Of the four major ingredients, we finally get to the yeast to the party, and that it makes a party. And so that's what happens in the fermentation vessels for us. Our ales ferment, are fully fermented in 5 days, and then we rest them for another 10 to 12 days, depending on the style of beer or how much through history of brewing it we feel like it needs to rest in order to have the flavor profile that we want. But that, in an essence, is what happened. Without going into all the biological and processes that happen. But the yeast does its work. It does what we hired it to do. It goes in there and it eats and consumes and reproduces, and we ended up with twice the amount of yeast that we started out with. We use up to, I think, 7 generations, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
7 generations of the yeast. We pitch half of it. You know, there's some dirty parts of it that are mixed, and then out of the center we're able to get a nice, healthy culture of yeast, and it just gets to live to go make another beer the next day, you know, and that's what we just keep propagating it and go on. And then once we've reached a lifespan or a history of the beer that gets to about 7, then we buy a new pitch of yeast, of new healthy yeast, and go from there and start with that new one.